Good evening, doctors. Welcome again. Our today's topic is renal stones. Question number, there is no question. We are going to discuss theory. Four types of renal stone. First one is calcium oxalate. This is the most common stone. Calcium oxalate is the most common. Then triple phosphate, cysteine stone, and uric acid stone. Okay, let's discuss about calcium oxalate stone. These are the most common stone. These are looking like mulberry or thorn-like surface. See? And by this way, it causes more hematuria, means blood in a urine due to its, remember this, these are the MCQs. Now, calcium oxalate stone looking like this, see this type stone looking like this, called mulberry stone, sharp projection, sharp, makes kidney beaded, bleed, hematuria, very hard, radio opaque stones. These are the radio opaque stones, remember it. Okay. Now, question number, triple phosphate stone. Triple phosphate stone, we can say Jack stone or struvite stone. These are the combination of calcium, magnesium, and ammonium phosphate. We can say this is a staghorn calculus or a smooth surface. That's why it produces less hematuria. I already written here less hematuria. Alkaline urine, we see this stone, and infection is protease infection here. Okay. And these are the struvite stones. See, struvite, Jack stone, or triple phosphate stones. Okay. Now, question number. Okay. Uric acid, we see radiolucent stone. Radiolucent stone is only uric acid kidney stones. Otherwise, all stones are radio opaque. I already done a line. X-ray KUB, 90% stones are seen on plain X-ray. Okay. And but for uric acid stone, we see acidic urine. Remember. These are the calcium stones, we can say mulberry stone, okay, or thorn like stone. Then triple phosphate stone, we can say struvite stone, Jack stone, or staghorn calculus. This is the uric acid stone looking like this, and this is the cysteine stone. Okay, now we are going to read about cysteine. Cysteine is a family. There is a double sulfide bond, see here, double sulfide bond, sulfur bond. And it is an autosomal recessive disorder in a young girl due to cystinuria, cystine in a urine. So let's discuss separately the kidney stone. Most common stone is calcium oxalate stone. It is mainly associated with protease infection. But we see gallbladder stone is a mixed stone most common. These are the brown stone. Infection is E. coli, and 90% is radiolucent here, and 10% is radio opaque. But in kidney stone, only uric acid stone is radiolucent, otherwise all stones are radio opaque. Remember. Now see, renal stone less than 2.5 cm, ESWL indicated, more than 2.5 PCNL percutaneous nephrolithotomy indicated, failed ESWL and PCNL open pyelolithotomy is indicated, open kidney from greater curvature side along with the Brodel's line. Then see ESWL for renal pelvis and upper ureter, ESWL indicated. For mid and lower ureteric calculi, ESWL is not helpful. For mid ureteric stone, we need to go for ureteroscopic stone removal. We can say this is URS. Okay. Now, this technique indicates the ESWL, see, by radiation. Okay. And this is the PCNL, see, I will show you. This is the eyepiece, this is ultrasonic probe, this is irrigation drain here, and these are the irrigation fluid we are going to inject here. This is the skin, and this is the nephroscope. This one is the nephroscope, remember to see, and breaking stone by this way, stone breaking by this radiations. Okay, PCNL. Now, phosphate stones. Phosphate stone is calcium phosphate stone, dirty white, radio opaque, alkaline urine. We see enlarged radio rapidly. These are stones are enlarged rapidly, and shape of calyx like staghorn calculus. Okay, move forward. Indication of ESWL in urology and non-urology. In urology, ESWL indicated, renal calculus less than 2.5, upper ureteric calculus, small vesicle calculus, and pyronyx. DS of pair. Then in non-urology, it's pancreatic stone indicated, CBD stones, ESWL indicated, and myositis ossificans. Then stent recommended prior ESWL is for calculi more than 1.5 cm. DJ stent before breaking. because a small stone is stuck in a ureter and it causes the infection. That's why we have to do DJ stunting than ESWL. Now, absolute contraindication of ESWL, this is pregnancy and bleeding diastasis. Relative contraindication is renal colic, urinary obstruction, infection, declining renal function, and significant hematuria. Remember, stricture or bacteria in circulation or causes urosepsis. Now, ESWL complication is hematuria, as we know, it is contraindicated. Then, stent recommended prior ESWL. PCNL indication when stone is more than 2.5. Infected calculi or cystine calculi. Remember this. Okay. Now I am going to make it little and large for this is more visible for you. Obstructive urophytes, failed ESWL, anatomic abnormalities and recurrent large calculi after open operation PCNL recommended. See, this is diverticular stone, diverticulum. This one is diverticulum. This one is kidney. And diverticulum to treat stone is PCNL recommended. Okay, I will show you more. If you want to resect this stone by PCNL, it is costal margin transcostal approach, so injury of pleura is common. But from below side, this one, this side, it is subcostal approach and injury of colon or bowel, we can say here. Now PCNL complications are what happens with PCNL complication, like bleeding. Septicemia can occur, perforation, pleural injury, duodenal colon injury, okay guys, and spleen injury and vessels injury. These are the complications of PCNL, remember. Now we see question. Locate the stone with pain radiating to the medial side of the thigh perineum in the males. It's pelvic bream. I will explain you everything, which stone radiates where and which pain is radiates to where. So I will show you this diagram. This is pelvis stone, renal pelvis. It's upper ureter stone. This one is upper ureter. This one is mid ureteric stone. This one I already explained. And this one is pelvic lower ureteric stone. So I will explain you why these positions are important and where the pain is radiated. See, position of stone. The PUJ upper ureter stone radiates pain in testes. If patient have upper ureteric stone, he has pain in testicles. Then middle ureter, crossing gonadal vessels ureter, main pain at McBurney point, right sided, resemble appendicitis. And a lower ureter at pelvic bream, then pain radiates to the groin, remember. Now question, it's fourth part, intramural ureter, ureteric muscles stone, then fruitiness, desire to micturation and painful. Okay. So guys, have a good day, goodbye, and that's all for today. I already finished with renal stones and their surgeries. And if you have any queries, any question regarding this, you can ask me. And these are the part of urology surgeries. Have a good day, goodbye. And if you still not subscribe my channel, please subscribe it. So guys, goodbye.